Okay, hello everyone. I am Ahmad, and today I'm going to present a new sample which enables editors and admins to copy pages across sites. But before that, let me introduce myself. I am Ahmad from Companion and Chat, and I work as a senior consultant, and I have almost 10 years of experience, and I'm located in Hamburg. My focus areas are Microsoft 365 development and solution architecture, AI and internet with SharePoint Agent and Copilot Studio, and as well as building like enterprise collaboration portals. Before we jump to the demo, let me explain what's the issue, what's the challenge which we have. Actually, managing content across multiple SharePoint sites is always challenging. So we always have this case where we need to have like unified structure, unified layout for certain departments, or if you have like locations, we need to have like unified design, unified branding. So sometimes it's challenging to do that with a solution out of the box. We have this feature to copy pages, but it's only it allows us to copy pages inside the same site, but it's not across or to another site. Yeah, this is, I think, from my opinion, sometimes it's time consuming, and therefore I come up with this solution. So copy pages. And this solution, as I said, so it enables editors and admins to copy pages from site to another site. So we can keep the same structure, we can keep the same web part, formatting, all of that will be preserved. This one, so it will keep like the branding unified for across all these sites, make it easier to copy one page to from site to another site. So this is an SPFx extension. So you can, there are multiple ways to do it. So you can have it like normal extension on all sites or on a certain site, or you can have it as a field extension inside the site pages library. So let me explain what are the key features for this solution. First, we have copy pages between sites, as I mentioned. So you can copy page from site A to site B. Second, you can also save a page as a template. So sometimes we have to copy page from A to B, but sometimes it's also possible we have a template, but we want to distribute it to multiple sites. Let's say we have an event, so we always have the same events, but we need to show this event in the IT site, maybe the HR, finance. So we can save this template in multiple sites. I can decide in the extension if I want to have it as a normal page or if I want to have it as a template here. Third, we can also decide if you want to publish it directly or if you want to save it as a draft. Because here we have multiple use cases. It could be, as I said, the same event for all departments. We just need to distribute it. So I can just copy it, I can publish it, that's it. But in some cases where we need to save it as a draft because we need to rework this page. It could be like, for example, FAQs, for example. So we have it for HR, but we just need to keep the same web part, the same structure, but the IT needs to add their own questions. So we can save it as draft, and the other department can directly work with this page. And lastly, we can decide also if we can save it as a normal page or as a news post. So this is like a toggle. You can decide if it should be a normal page or a news post. Yeah. Let me jump to the demo now. As you see, I have here human resources, and I want to, for example, to copy this start page to another site. So I have here software engineering, for example, and I have now this extension, as you see here. So when I click here, this dialog will be displayed. And on the top, as you see, I can select destination. So for example, in my case, I want to move it to the software engineering. I can click search for it. I'm using the PMP reusable component here for this destination selection. And for example, I want to move it to the software engineering. So I can select it. And now this selected site will be displayed here with a title and also with a URL. I can verify this is a correct site or not. In the next section, as you see, we have two toggles here. The first one on the left side, I can decide if I want to publish it directly. Or on the right side, I can also check if I want to change the promote status. As I said, when it's toggled, then it means this is a news post. When it's not toggled, it's a normal page. And then here, as you see, we have two buttons. The first, I can just copy it as it is, or I can save it as a template. But let me now start with copying this page. So when I click here, So it will be copied in the background. So now I have two options. So either I can make another copy, or I can just jump directly to the site to the where it was copied. So when I click here, for example, as you see, I have now new page here, as you see it here. So when I click here, so I have the same page. So as I said, this is a case where I want to have it as a draft, because the team could be, they want to change some of the data here on the this column on the right side, or they might then need to add their own content based on their requirements. Yeah. So now it's copied, but it could be also, I want to have it as a template as well. So I can go back, I make another copy. I can select, for example, again, software engineering. And as you see, so I can click here, but now it's being saved as a template, not as a normal page. I can jump directly there. I go to the template folders. And as you see, I have it as a template here. So as I said, this case might be more common, like an event, like event summary. It could be like where I need it in every site, so I can save it as a template. But as you see, I moved this page to the template folder. Now it will be stored as a template. I can reuse it. Yeah. So as you see, so I can just copy page across sites. I just need to add this extension. As I mentioned, so the original solution was built based on the field customizer, but I think it was retired, but now I think it was changed again, so it's not going to be retired. But the original solution was as a column here in the site pages library, where it was I can directly click here. This is one way to do it, or if you can do it, you can add it as a normal extension. So you can check the permission. If I have the permission, like I'm editor, if I'm admin, so I can see it and then I can move it. Yeah. Let me show you the code. So as you see here, I will not go through the code too much because I think we don't have much time. But as you see, we have two main hooks here. We have use copy hook. So this is the hook where I use it to copy the page. So as you see, we have the context, the page URL, the page name, the target site URL. These are the parameters which I need in order to move to copy these pages here.
Hey, Ahmed, could you just zoom in just a little bit for us, just so it's a little clearer and better for the video? Sure. Awesome. Looks great. Thank you so much. Okay. Yeah, perfect. Thank you.
Okay, great. Yeah, so as you see, we have this use copy page here. And I can here, I just need to check if I'm the status I'm submitting is done, message also to success or error. But these are the main parameters which I need to pass, the page URL, page name, target sites, and also the status of the form. And as you see here, we have this now, this context here, I'm calling the source site, and also, and then I need to go also the context of the target site. I call both of them, and I need to use this code here, or this API, so in order to copy the page. And as you see here, I need to pass the context of the target site. I need to, as I can add the page name, page title, and here I can decide if it should be published true or false, or promoted status here, where we decide if it's a normal page or if it is just a news post. Yeah. Here also where we check if it's a template, it already also be passed with a parameter, so I can check it with a template. If yes, then I can use it. So I can move it to the folder where we have a template. So I think with the graph API, you can do it in a different way. But the way I'm following here, I just check if there's a template folder, I just move it directly to this folder, then it will be taken as a template in this target site. As you see here, I just check here if it's we already have a folder for this template. We have another hook, as you see here. I used it here where I check the, for example, this template, so I can map the templates here. As I said, this is client side solution and backend solution. I will do it differently. I would check if it is if this template folder is created or not. I can create it with PowerShell maybe. But I think this case is client-side switch. I want to just keep it simple here. But as I said, we have two main hooks, the localization hook for the templates and the copy page. And I just move this page to the template folder if it's already existing there. Yeah. The main code, as you see, we have the page component. So I just have the dialogue. This is, and I have a form here where I have all the status which I need. As I said, I can publish, promote, template, all what I need here. Yeah, so I can just define it here. Let me jump back to the solution. So to the presentation. As you see, there are multiple ways to do it. So I think it's not one way, just I want it for the community. It's easier to have it in one package, one solution, just add it to the tenant and you have it here. This is one way to do it, yeah. But there are also other ways to do it. You can use also Power Automate, you can use the same extension, but instead of this use copy page hook, you can create another hook to trigger a Power Automate. It could be the case where you want an approval process in the middle, or you need to communicate with Microsoft 365 services, or to send an email. When it's copied, you want to send an email to the person. Yeah, it could be that you need to follow a certain process. So I think it would be better to use Power Automate here, not just directly on the client side. But as I said, also we have all these pros and cons here. So I think it will be a little bit slower because you need to send the request way to the maybe it could be an email, you will be notified with the email. It works a little bit differently, yeah. My preferred way would be Azure backend. So I to use like Azure Function in the backend. It is scalable, so you can create for like one target site or multiple sites, not one site. So you can make it a little bit more scalable. I think my opinion is better. And this is how it could be done in productive environment. I would do it this way. So we have the SPFx app. I click on it. The Azure Function app would be triggered. And this Azure Function app, I can copy it to one site or multiple sites. Or it could be like I can define multiple groups, for example, like for departments, locations. It should be copied to certain set of sites or one site or multiple sites. Also, I would do also to add like logs, also to just to log everything what's happening, even if it's successful, there's an error, just to have something like to audit this thing here. So as I said, my preferred way to be better to use backend. Yeah, this is what I would do on production environment. Yeah. If you want to check the sample, it's already existing on the PMP repository. You can just use this link here to check it. And that's all from my side. Thank you.